truly appreciate the collaboration we've had with Nakuru County, and we will continue forging it further. We welcome Dr. Kigondu. Dr. Kigondu is our Secretary General, National, and he's traveled all the way from Nairobi with his lovely wife, Koi. Please stand and say hi.
Good afternoon, everybody.
Koi is running a rehab in Nairobi and really doing some good work there. So if you have clients who need some rehabilitation, you can talk to her. So welcome, Dr. Kigondu. We truly appreciate your presence here.
Thank you, ladies and gentlemen of KMA Nakuru Division. I want to thank the team that has been running this division, and I think this division is one of the SI units of how to run a division in KMA. I want to thank the chairman, Dr. Otara, and I think he has done his course, and I think we want him at national level. He's up Mekua Mdogo sana, and I pay him a coffee. Wazee kama sisi at national level, we have to retire. We want the other ones like Otara. I will not take a long time, but I will want just to highlight a few points on an issue that is very close to my heart. I am a product of a health service commission, literally, and I think that all health workers, all health professionals deserve the same opportunity. I was trained by the government, work for the government, and I think the impact I have had on the government, on the population of Kenya, has been as a result of the possibilities of me being able to work under Health Service Commission. It was not called a Health Service Commission at that time, it was called the Public Service Commission. So maybe a small, my journey started in medical school, very hard, 6 years, very hard. And then we were posted to Machakos. Machakos, we revolutionized that hospital with a group of five. Those days, the young ones nowadays are lucky. We were only five interns, but we did a very good job. I did my medical officer. I was a medical officer in charge at Machakos Hospital. That's where I met my lovely wife. She was up on labor ward. In fact, that's why I did obstetrics. And then I was sponsored to go to Oxgain to school. University of Nairobi, by that same government, which so far, and they saw that if we sponsor this young man, then he's an asset to Kenya for the rest of us. So for 4 years, I was in University of Nairobi and did a million operations at Kenyatta. I did work in Otara, around the same time I was my senior. And after I left, I could not go back to Machakos, because in Machakos there was a gynecology. So then my now friend, retired director of medical services, Dr. Kimani, a lot of the doctors here know him, looked at the map of Kenya and decided Isiolo is where there was no gynecology. So I was posted to Isiolo as the first gynecologist, and actually I was the only consultant. Isiolo. So I went there, I took my family, we drove in a car far. We drove, then we reached Isiolo. We found a hospital. For 5 years I was there. I was the director of the medical superintendent, the gynecologist, and the DMSO, the structure there. And after Isiolo, I told the director that I'm missing my wife because I had to travel over the weekend. So I was brought nearer. Now I'm working for the county of Murang'a. And Murang'a is the SI unit of good health management. For new people in Nakuru, you need to come and benchmark, and we'll be talking to our governor to be teaching, bringing new people to benchmark in Murang'a as Nakuru. But I think Nakuru has also done pretty well. I think you are nearing Kenyatta as we are nearing Nakuru, I suppose, yeah? Yeah. So in a short while, I'll do a Health Service Commission presentation. And as you see there, I'm the Secretary General of Kenya Medical Association, but I am also at national level, at the council member of the National Executive Council of KMPTU. That's very important for working relations of the medical field. There was a lot of fragmentation. Oh, the KMPD, oh, the KMPD. So I decided to be now the confuser. You don't know whether you are in KMA, KMPD, but they're supposed to work together for the health of Kenyans, the benefit of Kenya. So there's a health service commission in Uganda. Why not Kenya? East Africa is having a protocol to sort of do things the same way. Uganda has been having a health service commission for the longest time. So why should Kenya not have a health service commission? We did a presentation as KMPTU to the parliament. We went to parliament and presented what the benefits of HSC are. And I just picked this slide, borrowed from Oluga, on what the rationale for a health service commission. There is a benefit to patients, the leveling of quality of healthcare services. I had the government here asking for specialists. You never get them without a health service commission. Tell your governor, former health service commission, to our trade pal in Nairobi, we send them. That is the only reason specialists were able to be distributed around the whole country. They reduce the cost of healthcare. The governor, in terms of paying health personnel, is only an ATM. Money comes from national through the governor to pay the health worker. So it should not be counted as an income in health to the government. And therefore, you reduce your cost of healthcare by giving the staff to a commission so that you concentrate on service delivery. Yeah? And the national government also benefits from accountability, improved human resource management system. Yeah? So then you have the health workers. The biggest issue why we need a health service commission is that the current county system of human resource does not support the growth of the health worker. The typical health worker is a doctor. He comes and works for 4 years, he gets burned out. Then he asks to be sent to school. The county says, no, we did not employ medical officers for 4 years. Therefore, you cannot go to school. Two, the guy has burned out. So the only option he has to is to resign and go. But us, after serving the counties for the time we needed, we were bonded. And we were sent to school and we came back, and the effects are felt to this day. All of you are products of a health service commission, so there's no reason why the younger generation, you should be giving them out to counties to finish their lives. So nowadays we have more, and our CEO is what we call amorphous. It's not a bad thing, but we are having more people avoiding clinical practice so that they move out of the county. We're having more people counting those who are working rather than, and it should be complete throughout. We cannot have people, a doctor, trained for 6 years, wanting to be more in administration than in surgery, pediatrics, psychiatry, you get. But this is an effect of poor HSN, and the Health Service Commission will help that. What are our steps towards the Health Service Commission? KMA, Dr. Kilonzo, gave presentations to the health process of Health Service Commission. We had a draft constitution, 2001, Health Service Commission there. Draft constitution, 2004, Health Commission was there. Constitution, 2010, Health Commission was there. Then a committee of experts retreated to somewhere near here, Naivasha, came out and removed the Health Service Commission from the draft constitution. They say we were sleeping, or there's nothing like that. They just removed the Health Service Commission from. I have written a lot, and if you go to my blog spot, you will see where the Health Service Commission was, when it was deleted, and health was also not devolved. It was devolved unconstitutionally. Why? We, Kenya Medical Association, gave how health should be devolved, and it was clear. The dispensary to Kenyatta, human resource management should be under national government, and the governor was supposed to sort out the primary health care and preventive medicine, like water, health services, you get primary health services. But the governors on June 2nd devolved health unconstitutionally. Why? Because they were looking at the money that had been generated between 2007 and 2013. Nakuru, PGH, Murema, it was Murema, was making, I think, like 100 million per quarter. The governor saw that, you know, that money is nice. But it was not meant to be like that. It was meant to be hospitals, national government. If you go to the legal notice of 2013, and reading is good, legal notice of 2013, it will tell you exactly which county hospitals were devolved. And there were the hospitals under the county, what about city councils, yeah? Nakuru Council then, and there were 256. The case against the constitutional devolution of health, I wrote the proceedings of that. I gave Omkata, I told him, go, this is how we have devolved health. It was recently in 2014, and there was an appeal in 2017, whose judgment has not yet come out. It was supposed to say that they unconstitutionally devolved health. That was a civil case 362, 2014, and the appeal of 2017. Latest, we as KMPDU have made a presentation to the BBI among health workers. Yep. And a lot of articles have been written on Health Service Commission. Mwachonda, the Deputy Secretary General of KMPDU, wrote Service Commission will redress health services. There's a very good health writer, Nasibo Kabane, who wrote why health commission is crucial for crippling crisis. Immediately after devolution, we have had 52 strikes of health workers. Something must be wrong. You can't have strikes every day and you're doing the same thing every day. The proposals of how to solve the health sector problems is people made presentation, people have been suffering, and they've said return the function to national government, but that brings a lot of problem with governance. They want help. Streamlining health service deliveries in the counties. BBI recommended a health service commission, but it made a very good recommendation. It says, BBI is funding a health service commission for management of human resource for health while retaining health function as a devolved function. That has always been what we have called for, but we have had this mantra of something follows the, what do they call it? Function. Money follows function. So when it is said that health is devolved, then also that means the money is devolved. But we need to go away from that and say human resources for health can be managed at a national level. Let the governor manage the hospitals and all. We have no problem. But human resources for health, make a health service commission. So how do you actualize the health service? The first option is a Chapter 15 commission, which is an independent commission with independent offices, where the controller of budget and auditor general see it as independent. These are like public service commission, judicial service commission, teacher service commission, and parliamentary and others. The ethics and option two is to an act of parliament. When they removed the health service commission from the constitution, they wrote a line. The health service commission has been removed because it can be brought in through an act of parliament. So it was actually not removed, but it was only that stated that an act of parliament, but I think they knew that health workers will not follow this up and that will lapse and there will be no act of parliament and there will be no health service commission. And that's why we've been having this problem. So ethics and anti-corruption commission has been created from an act of parliament. And that same statement of 2010 actually said ethics and anti-corruption commission can also be created by an act of parliament. So if ethics and anti-corruption commission is there, then also a health service commission, we can do an act of parliament to create it. And now everyone is talking BBI, even us, we have jumped into the BBI bandwagon, but not that we support the whole BBI. The other people can decide on what the government should look like, but for us, the BBI recommendation of a health service commission is what we want. Whether the BBI goes the referendum way or the parliamentary way, that's not a problem. Because the referendum way, the HSC will put it as a constitutional commission. If adopted, we need to discuss what is the effective date. I propose immediately it is adopted. The Chapter 13 Commission. Now, you have Chapter 15 and Chapter 13 Commission. Chapter 13 Commissions deal with public service. Public service commissions are PSC, TSC. They are Chapter 15 Commissions because they are also within the chapter, they deal with services. They are services oriented. And therefore, the HSC will also become a component of Chapter 13. The HSC will be unique in that all Chapter 15 commissions are national government. HSC's function will be devolved, but the human resource management will be at national funded. That will be the first commission where you have a national commission dealing with a devolved function, and that's how we want it. So, for instance, you have security, national police services, and national education, teacher service commission is not devolved. But it's not really not devolved because ECD is devolved. So HSC will also be there dealing with both national and devolved. So how will the HSC sit in commission? These are things that we need to think about. Article 235 of the Kenya Constitution gives the county governments a power to form their own county public service boards. Will this therefore be amended when the HSC is formed and only devolved function that the service commission at national level? These are things we need to think about when we are changing the law to accommodate Article 235. We need to define our relationships clearly in the constitution to say how we will be dealing with the county public service boards. And maybe let me add here. Nothing stops counties from employing their own doctors. A HSC does not stop counties from employing doctors. So in fact, this is a win-win situation where you have people from national government and the county employing where they, which is what we have always done in the past. Yeah. So public service commission have always had challenges in this area, and in health, we have also had challenges in this area. When you put an effort to put national standards, each county brings their own standards. For instance, Murang'a has the highest standards of healthcare, but across the county, in Kirinyaga, sorry, I'm not saying anything. While the HSC will deal with respective county governments or council of governors, so we need to think, are we dealing with council of governors, or will we be dealing with each government individually? These are things to think about. Then, we need to safeguard our health service commission proposal, which has been given to the BPI. It must come into the bill. How do we do it? Not in Bomas, they say those guys used to sleep. When they hear teachers are being devolved, they wake up and say no, then they go back to sleep. That's how we need at this point to safeguard the HSC. We need to participate in BPI validation town hall meetings. Have they come to Nakuru? Yes, when? They came, I think, yeah? Yes, you go there and say, you go and sleep, then you wake up and say HSC, and then you sleep again. Identify the areas of action during the validation. We need to influence those who are making presentations to put a good one for Health Service Commission, and we will circulate this so that you just be ambassadoring it everywhere. Influence participants in these town hall meetings and keep the HSC proposal alive. There will be a technical committee in the BPI. This will put the BPI recommendations into a bill of parliament, and the Health Service Commission must be put there. Political class, when you meet your governor, and I'll send my Naina to tell the governor, kuna pesa inachukuliwa governor, ni kusaidiwa to manage human resource for health. MCS body, tell them, a health service commission. Yeah, to copy the women, youth, and media. As you can see in media, we give them what a health service commission is, this part of education, so that the HSC proposals are mandated. So how do we operationalize the HSC? We decide whether it's a we'll go the referendum way or an act of parliament. We clarify the mandate between resourcing and supervision. The county is worried how will we supervise, but they also don't want to provide the resources. You get what I mean? He's saying that there is no super speciality to Amnoka, but when they come there, he wants to supervise them. So you need to clarify that mandate. And the Ministry of Health also, they are looking like you are taking a bit of bone away from them by forming a health service commission. Let them know, we are looking for our bone. They also have their bone. The HSC is not fighting with the Ministry of Health, but it's instead helping them. So we need to define all the powers of the commissioner, see the TSC wrangles, and the membership of the commission. We need to, the challenges will be to clarify. And, investigation has shown that the biggest impediment to a health service commission is the doctors and the other health workers. You see, there are some people who are happy, the county is treating them well, they are seeing as if your health service commission comes, watatuma Mandela. So they are the same. So this, we must educate people on the posterity and goodwill, and that they will not go to Mandela. You see, people are not just transferred arbitrarily, there are rules and regulations. Autonomy, will it become an appendage of MOH? You see in TSC and you don't know where the instructions are coming. What are the, will they be conflicting with the unions? What is the composition? And this composition issue is a problem. It's just saying, madatari, wanataka tu kuwa, hao ndio wakubwa. You get, this brings a bit of who is qualified to be in the TSC. So the steps we need to make as KMA, we need to lobby, we need to shadow the post-BBI task force process, we need to have a team to clarify what a HSC devolves state, so that you persuade your doubters, so that when someone asks you, when you ask people, EAC, Nini, you just answer them. Identify the opposers and show them the value proposition, the governance. We have showed a few, they actually want to hand over, it's only that they don't know how, you know, but we will show them. We need a communication strategy for KMA, and the strategy will be that we need a constitutional commission if we have to go the referendum way or an act of parliament. There have been bills. The Chuka MP Patrick Munene drafted the HSC Act. We assisted. There was a Health Act of 2017, which is a Kenya Health Human Resource Advisory Council. The problem with that is advisory. Advice can be taken or not taken. So it has no power. We at Takio, we want a HSC. The Constitution of Kenya Amendment. Now, going back to 2012, our very old Professor Lukoya Atwoli actually helped in drafting the HSC. And you can see, it's the Constitution of Kenya Amendment Bill 2012. This was to entrench the Health Service Commission into the Constitution. And we went through the articles and said, on Article 235 of the Constitution will be amended by inserting Health Service Commission. Insertion of Part 4, Article 237A of the Constitution. The Constitution amended by, we actually went through the law. We have a bill, we are just waiting to implement it. Article 6, 248 amended, inserting the following paragraph immediately after Health Service Commission, and we are to get representative of a Health Service Commission into the Salaries and Remuneration Commission. These things are there. We have the personnel in KMA to actually do that bill, and we have done it. But good will. We don't know why people don't want a health service commission. Always think of your children. So the latest one has been the KMPDU presentation, which was done in Parliament, and I think it's online and was adopted by the BBI committee. And Kenya Medical Association provided the venue for the health professional associations and societies and unions, HSC effort. There was a group of nurses, clinical officers, that was, and there was a meeting on January 22nd at KMA Center. So our contribution as KMA is venue and logistics. And people are discussing how to operationalize the HSC. And KMA is also represented in KHF. Now here, which a lot of them, they are private practitioners who are wondering, what is the benefit of HSC in private practice? All the doctors who work for you in private were trained in government, and they were trained by Health Service Commission, and that's why they are quality. When you have people now leaving immediately after internship and trying to treat coughs and colds, after 1 year, they will have no skill at all. You must have a minimum of about 2 years of working in government or in a busy institution if you want to. Clinical practice is about practice, and that can be done usually in the public sector. Yeah. So the KHF is having a discussion, and they have asked for proposals of health services. It benefits the health. The private sector cannot train professionals. It's too expensive, and also to acquire the skill. And therefore, we want the private sector also to support this. And with that, I think when Melissa becomes a pediatrician in 2032, she will just be employed by the HSC, and her skills, she'll continue treating asthma and babies. And thank you very much.
Thank you so much, Dr. Kigondu. Very stimulating talk. I can see Dr. Mwangi is preparing the question. I give you 30 seconds.
1 minute. 1 minute or 60 seconds. Thank you. That was a very nice presentation, Dr. Kegodu. I think we've come a long way from those days we were just making statements and you're not going into the details. A few points I noticed from your presentation. Professor Atori had actually written something there about having a representative in SRC. Actually to entail a change of Article 230 of the Constitution.
Yes.
For you to have that as a member, HSC to be a member. We also are to blame because when Professor Aukot came here to Nakuru, when the Constitution was just a draft, I mean, I was the only doctor who went to talk about HSC. The other doctors were nowhere to be seen.
So operating. You know the doctors, yeah. Things go away. They so operating.
We didn't understand.
That's it. So when I raised the issue with Professor Aukot, because we were hoping if we had enough numbers, we can push, tell him to put it in the final draft. He told me that he's already taken care of in the Constitution, the Health Service Commission. Now the other point to note is that much as ESC got a commission through an Act of Parliament, the Health Service Commission is actually touching the devolution in a way because the governors will want to know whether the money that is devolved is going to be reduced. Since it is touching, there may be an element of requirement of a referendum because of touching on devolution. That's my comment, and maybe we need to go delve more and find out how practical it is to have all that. There's also Article 250. I don't know whether I saw it.
We did put all the articles. Yeah. That amendment bill is very long.
Yeah, because that's where we have all the commissions in Article 250 of the Constitution, and it needs to be included there. So there's a big change in that Constitution. But today I understand when I read the whole Constitution why Professor Okoto was saying that it is actually covered in a certain way. Thank you.
That young man, he looks like you have understood. Thanks, Katari, for that talk. Eh? It seems we are looking for the Health Service Commission as a compromise with the governor. We are telling the governor that if you give us the staff, we give you the equipment. That thing will come back to bite us. Let's take everything. For instance, if we say the central government is managing the personnel, then this governance, like now there is a cancer age, everybody wants an oncology center. So we have all the governors buying radiotherapy units, so we have 47 radiotherapy units. And then nobody thinks there's a heart problem, so nobody has bought a cardiac unit, isn't it? But somebody, if it was controlled centrally, somebody would say, let's buy a radiotherapy unit in Muranga, cardiac unit here, so it should be coordinated. We cannot have this governance running this thing. So let's not compromise. Let's go for the referendum and let's take the lead on.
I can inform you, actually, the blueprint and the former DMS, Dr. Kimani will tell you, the blueprint was very simple. Health was looked at, it was a national function, and there were two things that they looked at. MES, HSC. You get the point. It was actually there. So when these people asked for humanists for help, national government threw the human personnel and kept the MES. Okay. It was actually one program. It was a well-designed program, and I sort of agree with you. Governors were here, kitu kidogo.
I don't think we need to give governors anything because one, they are illiterate. And we don't, let us not mince our words, they are illiterate. In terms of medicine, they are illiterate. They can be literate in politics, but in terms of medicine, they understand nothing. And it is us who understand, who must drive this vehicle, not them. I think they have taken a lot of time to talk to the Speaker of Senate at one time. And I know we had a very hot argument about the National Health Service Commission being a national thing and the coalition, and they insisted this thing must go through Parliament. I think the KMA must drive this thing to go to referendum. Let us not even give it that chance, unless we are hitting the wall But a referendum would be the easiest way to, and it is good thinking, like all people of intelligence. Once the referendum passes today, the following day everything is law.